Hi, everyone, and welcome to the Big House. This massive crowd assembled here today to cheer on the Wolverines, already chanting Go Blue. We've got a tremendous matchup for you tonight. Tailgating has been going on since the early morning, and this place is locked and loaded. As we'll see a team from the ACC, the North Carolina Tar Heels, taking on the ninth-ranked team, the Michigan Wolverines. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, joined here in the booth by Kirk Herbstreit. Kirk, let's get to the action on the field. And the Wolverines will kick this away to get us going. And here's the return from inside the five. Coverage team brings down the returner. So the North Carolina Tar Heels special teams don't do the offense any favors with that return. And there comes the star running back onto the field. He is a special talent. You talk to opponents, he's always the focal point when they face this offense.
Boy, Chris, this guy is special. It's almost like he floats across the field. I mean, I don't think anyone can take him down in the open field. He's the guy that teams try to key on, but sometimes it feels as though no one can contain him.
Costly holding penalty there. Backs him up 10 yards. Just underway, and this home crowd is fired up and ready to make a difference today. Gonna run it. It's Hampton. Finding space at the 20. And the defense wraps him up.
Chris, I know it's the first play of the game, but boy, nice job by this offensive line. The back gets behind him, picks up some positive yards.
Second down after that previous play. To throw, it's Johnson. And he finds the running back in the flat. Great cut, they whiff on him. Good execution. Gets a block and gets the first down.
Defense kind of lost a running back here. Makes a nice catch and gets the first down in the process.
And the Tar Heels hustle to the line to run the hurry up. On first and 10, they'll look to throw it. But they don't make the connection. That one is incomplete. Offense getting set. It's second down. After the incompletion on first down, looking to throw. The pass is intercepted. Going the other way, can they catch him? Out past the 30. At the 10 now. Touchdown, Michigan. And the defense adds 6 to the interception return.
Boy, that's a 14-point swing on the opening drive. Instead of worrying about giving up points, not only they come up with this interception, but to take it into the end zone, they're an extra point away from really giving their offense an edge.
So they'll try to add to the lead now to the PAT. PAT makes it 7-0. Now the kickoff team is out on the field. Fields it just outside the goal line. He'll be tackled at the 18. That's good coverage there. And here comes the North Carolina offense back out onto the field. They have got to bounce back on this possession after throwing a pick six last time out here. goes backwards, losing 3 yards there. And they don't block the defensive end, who shows some quickness, Kirk, getting around the edge that time.
Yeah, this guy's usually getting around the edge to put pressure on the quarterback, but he reminds everybody here that this guy's a complete package. Not only can he pressure the quarterback, but also he is very, very talented and shows you the physicality he has against the run as well.
To throw, it's Johnson. Not able to hook up there, incomplete.
Man, Chris, I don't know if that was a bad read by the quarterback or a bad route by the receiver. They got to get this cleaned up before the next time they go through the air.
Well, a serious challenge for this offense. You don't want to be in third and long inside your own 20. How much of a risk will they take to try to pick up this first down? He's got a man down the middle. Tackle made after a solid gain. They'll spot the ball at the 34.
What a clutch play here by this offense to convert on third down. I know it's still early in this game, but the fact that they've dug themselves a hole to convert there and keep this drive alive, they got a new set of downs and a chance to dig into this lead.
Trying to find room. It's Hampton. And he's brought down, but hold on, there's a flag on the play.
Hold it.
It stings for the offense. Penalty will cost him 10 yards. Big guys up front lined up. It's first down. They call the draw play here. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Man, the defensive coordinator has to be fired up about this play. The thing that he has to love is that his defense and their technique was right on point. They didn't lose their leverage. They stayed with the play and didn't just go after the quarterback.
He went backwards on first down, so second and long from the 24. There's the snap. Quarterback setting up to throw. Short pass finds the tight end. They bring him down. That's a very solid gain, but still well short of the first down.
Well, this is what coaches love to see. A quarterback with the ability to read the defense properly and then just get it to the open man. Sometimes it sounds simple, but it's tough to execute. This time we have good recognition by the quarterback, and he gets it down to the tight end. You can see what he can do after the catch.
And he'll drop back here on third down, looking for his back. Grab down the middle. It's Hampton. An explosive play, big gain across midfield to the 42.
Oh, my gosh. What a great play by the offense. And on the other side, how frustrating for this defense. They had everybody covered downfield. The quarterback looks like he's almost giving up on the play, checks it down to the running back, and how about the back, what he does with the ball in his hands after the catch, picks up the first down.
Trying to flex the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff, and they'll stop him after a short gain.
Chris, you know, the spread era over the years has always grown offensively, but what I've been always impressed with the defenses that really build their defense to play in space still have an ability to be sound at the line of scrimmage and defend a running game. It's exactly what we saw right there.
That one falls incomplete, looking for a flag, doesn't get it, brings up third down.
What a hit there by the defender. Tough for the receiver to hold on to the football when he has that kind of contact. Good, clean play by the defense.
After the incompletion, they'll have to try to convert here on third and nine. Back to throw. It's Johnson. It's a deep throw down the right sideline. He's got it near the end zone. And he's in. Touchdown, UNC. Looked like a total bust there. Easy pitch and catch like you'd see in a Tuesday practice.
Yeah, that quarterback's eyes must have lit up on that play because you've got one of your players way downfield without any defender around him.
Now they line up to kick the extra point. And the PAT is good.
The extra point is good. That ties the game at 7.
Now they get set to kick it away. And he takes this from inside the 5. And he stopped at the 20. Tried to make something happen, but that's good coverage there. So Michigan's offense out there for their first possession. All right, Kirk, let's take a quick look at the impact players for today's game and how they're going to affect the outcome.
These are your leaders on the field and in the locker room. These are your go-to guys, not only when you need a play to be made, but also when you need somebody to rally your team.
They make the tackle there, but a penalty marker is on the field. Let's see what that's about. See if the offense can overcome that holding penalty. First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? He'll hand it off. They get him to the ground about the 18-yard line.
I think this defense keeps thinking about them throwing the football, and by doing that, they're opening up running lanes. Good positive yards there by the running back.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Ball handed off. They stop him right at the 24.
It's not a huge gain here, but if you add up multiple runs like that throughout the course of a game, by the fourth quarter, you're going to start to see that affect the defense.
So the offense getting set. This is not where you want to be against this defense. Third and long. Handing off on the draw play. Making people miss. They bring it back to the 38, but that's good enough for a first down.
I like how the offensive coordinator here is getting pretty creative. Defense is obviously expecting a pass, so he decides to catch him off guard and goes with the draw play. Going to have to be more aware of that going forward.
The Wolverines will line up on first and 10. Off the play fake, looking to throw. And he dumps it off to the tight end.
Well, that's pretty good coverage here by this defense. Not much of a window to throw this ball into, but the quarterback's accuracy and the size of the tight end picks up a nice game.
What's the play call here on second down for this offense? And the ball is handed off out of the shotgun. And he's brought down, but not before he gets first down yardage.
Of course they're going to pick up the first down by running the football. You think about Michigan, you think so many legacy, incredible backs that they've had over the years. Tim Biakabatuka, Tyrone Wheatley, and Leroy Hoare. Man, so many good backs have come through Ann Arbor.
The Wolverines pick up enough for a first down. They'll run it out of the shotgun. And the defense smothers him for no gain.
Well, that's an excellent effort here by this defense, staying in their run fits. They holding their own at the line and making the tackle. The offense just couldn't get enough of a push to get anything going there.
He hands it off from the gun. A change of direction. Brought down, but broke the tackle to produce a solid gain there.
You know, a lot of people feel running backs with elite speed shy away from contact. But that wasn't the case there. Instead of running around the defender, this back elected to run right through him.
One of those critical third down plays coming up. Back to throw. It's Orgy. Fires it to the wideout. Cannot connect. Incomplete. And now fourth down.
Well, it looked like the quarterback had everything that he needed there. Had great protection. Receiver ran a nice route. Just not able to convert there on that third down. Let's see what their decision is on fourth down coming up.
And the Wolverines will come to the line on fourth down, hoping to keep this drive going. Fourth down, he's throwing for it. Finds his man, has the first down. May wrap him up, but the gain is good enough for a first down.
That's a pretty good job here by the defense, really, on this fourth down. They took away all his intended receivers. He just checks that down as a last-ditch effort. Give credit to the back for picking up that first down.
First down and 10. Quarterback keeps the football. The pickup is 7 yards, now second and 3.
Ooh, that came close to breaking into the secondary, potentially a big play. Read option, and quarterback keeps it. And while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yards. Only a nice tackle prevented it from going all the way.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Here comes a handoff. And they tackle him, but not before he picks up the first.
One way to create a rhythm and really start to show your identity as an offense is to control the line of scrimmage. The offensive line here early getting a hat on the hat, and this back, as good as we've seen all year, with the ability to accelerate through the hole, positive yards, play after play here early in the game.
Quarterback still with the football. Has the first down, still on the move. And the runner brought down, but looks like there's a flag on the field. Let's see what this is about. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. Offense will keep it on the ground here. He'll be brought down just a few inches short of that first down mark.
I tell you, to be able to pick up a nice gain like that, those offensive linemen have to sustain their blocks. Gave him a chance at a really nice gain.
The Wolverines are in the red zone now. Here's a quick throw off the play fake. Tackle, but only after picking up a fresh set of downs. First down play call. How aggressive will it be? Handoff in a single back formation. Able to fight for a decent gain here in that running play. So here comes second down now. Every play important down here in the red zone. Tailback with another carry. And the senior able to make the stop after a short gain. And a player is down injured after that last play. We'll take a timeout while they check him out. Offense facing a third down now. They can still get a first down without scoring. And they're moving the receiver now before the snap. Dropping back, it's Orji. Receiver makes the grab. Tackle is made at the four. It'll be first down and goal.
Well, that's exactly how you dice up a zone coverage. Nice throw downfield here on third down, and a really good route to give the quarterback a chance to make that play.
The Wolverines line up with a first and goal. They'll try to run it in on first and goal. He's swallowed up at the line, could not get past that big defensive tackle. So some early drama here. We're all even at the end of one. Let's take a quick pause and check out the stats from this first quarter. And as we move to the second quarter, we hope these teams will build on a promising start. Second down and goal upcoming. Out of the shotgun, he'll hand it off. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
What a great play by the defense here. Getting close to the goal line. Not only do they come up with a big stop, but they send them backwards in the process.
Ball spotted at the five for this third and goal play. Here's the snap, looking to throw. Catch made in the end zone. Touchdown, Wolverines. Tight end was wide open. How do they lose track of the big fella down there, Kurt?
I don't know. I wish I knew. The defense, to me, looks like they just were so locked in on defending the goal line, they forgot about the tight end. That'll probably be the easiest touchdown throw and catch we see of the game today.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with a PAT. The extra point gives them a 14-7 lead. Kickoff team has come on the field now to send this one away. Return starts from inside the five. Not much on the return. They'll stop him at the 24. Good coverage. And the North Carolina offense is back out there on the field. They were able to punch it in the end zone last time. Looking to do the same thing here to see if the defense can make adjustments. Tackle made after a solid run by the junior.
You know, everybody always wants to talk about quarterbacks today and receivers. And don't get me wrong, that's a big part of the evolution of the game and where we are. But, man, for me as a fan, when I'm watching a game, there's just something satisfying about the teams and the offenses that still have backs that can carry the ball and come up with plays like that. Move those sticks and keep this drive going.
Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of two.
I mean, Chris, you have to admire this offense. They continue to try to sprinkle in the run game, even though it's not been able to really get established. But they're not just becoming one-dimensional. You got to respect that, and hopefully at some point it'll pay off.
Now it's second down here. Handoff here from the shotgun. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of two.
Man, this defense continues to just be physical at the line of scrimmage. Offense can't do anything on the ground. And by doing that, this defense is allowing their defensive front to get pressure on the quarterback. Every time they drop back to throw, they become a one-dimensional offense.
Now in third and very long, looking to throw. Just trying to get rid of it. Able to get the pass away, but took a hit that time.
Boy, this is all about the defense here. Nice stop here on third down, but really it's about trying to get this offense behind the sticks. Once you get them behind the sticks, you can mix up your coverages, really affect the quarterback's eyes and disrupt the timing and the rhythm of what the offense is trying to do. Now we've got another big fourth down coming up.
On the return, it's Morgan. He's brought down, but a good effort to make something of that return. And the Wolverines offense is back on the field. In the last possession, the defense just had no answer for this powerful ground game. Let's see what they can do this time. And it's incomplete as he just overthrew his receiver that time.
Well, this quarterback and his receivers have got to get on the same page. They've got to find a rhythm if they want to move the ball down the field.
So, second down after the incompletion. Play action fake, looking to throw. Lets it go quickly. And he's got his man open downfield. And he's brought down, but there is a penalty marker out there. Let's check out this call. Offense will have to overcome the holding penalty now. Getting set. Here's second down.
Reverse.
Nowhere to go, and the ball is knocked loose. Defense grabs the football. It's a turnover.
I get being upset at the ball carrier for coughing up the ball, but let's not ignore how big of a hit that was. Sometimes you just have to give credit to the defender for making a great play.
The offensive coordinator begins this drive with excellent field position. And they'll keep it on the ground. Running back has the handoff. Fighting him off. And the tackle is made, but let's check out what this flag is about.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. First down here for this offense. One man to the backfield, and he'll get the football. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there. Well, they run it right into a blitz. That linebacker was coming down hill, Kirk.
Man, what a time to call that blitz here by the defense coordinator. You're right, he shoots right through that A-gap. Really, the back had nowhere to go. By the time he got the ball in his hands, the linebacker's right in his face.
Back to pass. It's Johnson. The pass rush closing in. Cannot escape that ferocious pass rush. It's a sack.
Just outstanding combination of quickness and strength here by this Michigan defensive lineman. Makes me think of Aiden Hutchinson, who of course played here recently. Going back to guys like Rashawn Gary, Lamar Woodley, Frank Clark. Great tradition of Michigan defensive linemen on full display right now.
Now it's third down and long. They would hate to waste this great field position. And the quarterback dropping back, looking to set up a screen pass here. And he breaks the tackle on the way to a solid gain there.
Great job here by the defense. Third down and long. You drop back in coverage, keep everything in front of you, force that quarterback to have to check the ball down, and then you rally to the football to force his fourth down. Great job here by the D.
So now on fourth down, out comes the field goal unit. This will be a 39-yard attempt. And the field goal is good.
Yeah, I was watching this guy in pregame. He has got a strong leg. Not surprised here he's able to put 3 points up here for the offense.
So after the field goal, the kicker out there again to boot it away. He thought about returning it, but instead takes a knee. It'll be a touchback, and they'll start at the 25. And the Michigan offense back out on the field. On the run, it's Edwards. They bring him down, but the drive has now reached the 35.
Look, I realize on any play call, when it's properly executed, it can go to the house for a touchdown. But the runs that really make a game plan work are the ones where you get just what you need. And he barely got the first down, but he got it.
This line getting set up. It's a first down play. Hand off to the single back. They've got him down out near the 40.
Chris, it's the consistency of this back that has given this defense some fits. They've got to come up with some changes up front. This guy's already over 50 yards, and if he keeps running the way he is, not only is he having a great day, but it's going to give this quarterback a chance to hit some big plays downfield off play action.
Play action fake, looking to throw. Trying to create outside the pocket now. He'll avoid the big hit with the slide.
How about this by the quarterback? He takes a negative play and turns it into positive yards and slides down before taking a big shot. It's an excellent job of getting down to avoid that big hit.
Offense looking to convert on third and short from the 42. Can they make the yardage or face a tricky fourth down decision? They'll try to move the chains here on the ground. Right down at the 46, good enough for a first down. Looks like a player is down injured at that last play. We'll take a timeout where they check it out. And the Wolverines are moving quickly down the field. And then first down, right back to the running game. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. That was that excellent linebacker with a clear path just running downhill quickly.
You know, I think one of the great things about watching this guy play all year is his vision. He just has great instincts. That time the defensive line ate up all the linemen, freed up the linebacker to get into the backfield, and the result is a tackle for a loss for the backer.
Scanning the field, it's Orgy. That pass is caught. Breaking free at the 35. And a big gain before he goes out of bounds. The offense keeps churning, gets a fresh set of downs.
That's a nice completion here by this Michigan offense. And when Michigan is really clicking, you think about over the years, they've been efficient within that passing game, being able to throw the football to complement a very physical running game. Nice play.
Off the play fake, looking to throw on first down. Makes a quick catch. They bring him down, but a big chunk of yardage on the play. That's a nice pickup there. They find some space in the zone and pick up the first down.
Yeah, really nice call here, Chris, to be able to pick up this first down on this drag route. The quarterback does a nice job of being patient, waiting for that window to open up in that zone, and he put it right on the money for the receiver to have a chance to not just catch it, but eventually get the first.
The Wolverines with first and 10 here. And the running back takes the handoff and is able to find some running room. Nice pickup.
Just love watching this back run. Gets behind that offensive line, lowers his pads, and gets a nice solid game.
So down here in the red zone, every yard tough to find. Here is a crucial play coming up. Using his legs, it's Edwards. Brought down at the 3-yard line, but this offense now has a first down and goal right there.
It was a nice job up front by the offensive line, but give the running back an assist for setting those blocks up before he's able to get downfield for the first down.
The Wolverines looking to cap the drive here. It's first and goal. Oh, looks like the defense jumped offside there. If that's the case, this will be a first down. Offense will take the penalty, move them a little farther away from their own goal line. The offense threatening, close to the goal line with a new set of downs. And they're trying to punch it in here. And the running play gets stuffed. They're going to mark him right at the one.
The defense made a good play there, but needs to string along more stops like that against this running back if they want to be able to win this game. The run game has looked good in the first half, but maybe that won't be the case from now on.
And the defense bringing out some big bodies to stop the run. On the ground, trying to muscle it across the line. And this one goes nowhere. Lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Well, they came very close to punching that one in, and now third down and goal. And if I'm the OC, I challenge my offensive line in that back. I just slam it right back into that A-gap and try to overpower that defensive front.
So nothing on the previous play sets up a third and goal from the one. On the ground, trying to power toward the goal line. And he runs it in for the score. Touchdown, Michigan. Can you say methodical, marathon march, Kirk, just pounding away and wearing down that defense?
They just kept moving the sticks and moving the sticks until they got into the red zone, and they just kept moving the sticks until they got into the end zone. What a drive.
And now they'll set up for the point after.
The kicker is on for the extra point.
They had the extra point, and the lead now is 11, 21-10. The kickoff team on the field now as they get set to send this one away. And the return starts just inside the end zone. Solid job by the coverage team. They bring him down at the 16. And the Tar Heels offense is back out on the field. Difficult to win games kicking field goals. To cut into this lead, they got to find the end zone. Nowhere to go here in the ball. And this is going to be a safety. Able to get the ball back, but it could still be a drive kill.
Well, you just got to have more awareness here as a ball carrier. What in the world are you doing? You're on your side of the 50. You're running backwards like that. Eventually, the defense sees this. They can't believe their eyes. They're rallying to the football, and they come up with a safety.
So the safety will set up a free kick. They'll boot it away from their 20. With the return, it's Morris. He's tackled at the 34 after a decent kick return there. So the first play of the drive coming up here, under 3 minutes to play before half. Using the ground game here, tailback has the handoff. They've got him down out near the 40.
I'll take that every single time. Offensive line does a nice job up front. This back's vision and ability to get positive yards by lowering his pads on full display right there.
It's the two-minute warning. We've got a blowout developing here before halftime. Offense getting set. Second down play here. Back to pass. It's Orgy. He's got an open man downfield, and it's caught. It's a huge gain. The stop is finally made at the 41-yard line.
It's really good timing here between the quarterback and the receiver. And how about the receiver downfield? Does a nice job of finding that open space in the zone of the defense. And as a defense, you're just basically throwing your hands up in the air because they had that covered relatively well. Just a good play call and good execution.
That one falls incomplete. Good defensive play brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out the punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, he's unable to hold on to the football.
Incompletion sets up a second down. From the shotgun, he's probing the secondary. Looks downfield, he connects with a wide open wide receiver. Tackle made after a big game.
This offense is clicking, and clearly everything seems to be working. Coordinator is calling good plays, the quarterback and the rest of his receivers and running backs are executing, and frankly, this defense is showing almost no resistance.
And the Wolverines have first and 10 here. Here comes a throw from the red zone. With the catch, it's Loveland. He takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Wolverines. Well, the call was sort of predictable, Kirk, but that tight end is just so tough to stop down here in the red zone.
Listen, speaking on behalf of all quarterbacks, you get down in the red zone, you're looking for that big target that you can trust. He's going to run a good route, and he's got a big wingspan to allow you to make a throw up into the air. He can go up and make a catch over most defenders. Really good execution. They come up with six.
Here comes the point after attempt.
The kicker is on for the extra point.
After the PAT, the lead is 20. So after the touchdown, here's the kickoff, and we'll see if the opposing offense has time to answer before halftime. Fields it inside the 5-yard line. And he stopped at the 19. Good job by the coverage team. And here comes the North Carolina offense back out onto the field. They've got a choice here in the final minute. Do they get aggressive, try to cut into this lead, or play it safe and point toward the second half? They make the tackle, but not before a solid gain on that pass. Looks like a man is down on the field after the last play, so we'll take a timeout. Offense getting set up. Here's second down. Looking to pass. It's Johnson. Receiver looks it in. It's complete. And the gain just good enough for a first down. A new set of downs after that completion. First down. Looking to throw the ball. Goes to his right side there for the completion. Then he'll run out of bounds after picking up a few yards on the play.
This is an example of a quarterback and his offense just taking what the defense gives you. Not a huge play, but positive yards. The defense wants to give that throw to you. Take it, get the ball to your receiver, stay ahead of the sticks.
Quarterback wants to throw it on second down. Caught near the sticks. It's Hampton. Timeout is called to talk strategy late in this close game with halftime approaching.
Well, it's so easy to get caught up in the receivers and the quarterback, and your eyes get lost. You forget about the running back. Nice catch and a first down for this offense.
Caught over the middle. It's Hampton. They bring him down, but a solid gain there on first down. Looks to be just inches short of the marker.
A running back who can take a check down like that and turn it into a gain can be a quarterback's best friend. And it's an easy way to rack up those touches and get the ball to your playmaker in the open field.
So the offense takes the field in the final seconds of the half. Chance for just a couple more plays. And it's complete downfield. Heads out of bounds after a solid gain, more than enough to pick up a first down.
The defense is spread all over the field, creating some one-on-one matchups, and the quarterback makes them pay for it.
And the Tar Heels are in the red zone. To the air, it's Johnson. Looking to the end zone. Looking for a touchdown, but it's incomplete.
You know, I like the quarterback's patience here, and instead of trying to force the issue and squeeze the ball into coverage, he just decides to just basically throw it away and live for the next down.
So just before halftime here, out comes the field goal unit. And it's good, right down the middle. And that field goal, the final play of this opening half.
Michigan, 30, North Carolina, 13.
And that is going to wrap up the first half here. Let's kick it now to Kevin Connors with our halftime update.
Guys, it is tough to beat the Big House when it's full and rocking as it is today in Ann Arbor. And it'd be easy to say these two offenses are glad we've hit halftime based on their respective performances. It would also be accurate. Turnovers and sacks have told the story so far. And you gotta believe the play calling has been the issue, right? Time to shred those game plans and just get back to basics. Either way, it's time to find out. Back to the best in the biz for the start of this third quarter.
And the Tar Heels will kick this away to get the second half going. He's going to return it from near the goal line. He'll be tackled at the 27. That's where the drive will start. And the Michigan offense comes back out on the field. They take the field with serious momentum. They have been tough to stop so far. Can they keep it going? A gain of 2 yards, and now it's second down and 8.
You know, in the era that we live in right now, everybody wants to spread the field around, try to create space, try to create one-on-one matchups, and the defense is countered over the years by trying to play out wide. But here's a great example of a defense has the ability to play wide, but still be solid at the line of scrimmage and not give up big run plays.
Looking downfield, it's Orji. Quarterback moving out of the pocket, trying to create. Slides to avoid the big hit.
Well, they did a good job of getting pressure on the quarterback, but man, make the play, bring him down. Instead, they give up positive yards here on the scramble.
Offense gets set up here. It's third down. Can he get there on the ground? The Wolverines are on the move here.
How impressive have these guys been up front today? Big third down. Know what you need to do. Get the first down. Continue to hold on to that lead. Continue to work clock and get that much closer to securing a victory.
The Wolverines begin a new series here, first and 10. Now they'll switch it up, looking to throw the ball here. And it's just beyond the receiver's grasp. Too much on that one.
From the snap of the ball, it looked like he knew exactly where he wanted to go with the football. But the guy just had him blanketed, and he still tried to get the ball squeezed in there. He's got to do a better job of working through his progressions to find that open man.
So after the incompletion, it's second down. They'll run it here. Gets the first and still running. It's a big gain across midfield all the way to the 39-yard line.
There's nothing more that helps an offense than committing to that running game and popping an explosive run like this on the ground. Keeps the confidence of your offensive lineup. Same with your back. It helps everything else that you're doing as an offense in your rhythm. Now you can come back with some counters, try to take some shots off of play action, and keep hammering away with that run game.
And the Wolverines will try to keep this drive moving. He's escaping the pocket now. He'll avoid the tackle there with a slide.
Chris, watch him work through his progressions here. Finds the first and the second option are there. By the third option, he's got to pull it down and try to pick up some positive yards, of which he did, and then he slides down to avoid the big hit.
Fresh set of downs for the offense. First down. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Grab down the middle. It's Moore. And he's tackled only after picking up a first down.
You know, this is what makes this receiver so dangerous. If you play him in man, he can run by you for a big play. You decide to sit back in zone, and he's got the savvy and instincts to be able to find that soft spot in the zone, make a catch, and be dangerous after the catch as well.
Snapping it from the red zone now, looking to throw. And it's the senior getting home with the sack.
Chris, that's on the offensive line right there. They definitely have to be feeling responsible because it's almost like you didn't protect your little brother back there.
So this offense faces a second and 15. The O-line needs to regroup. From the shotgun, it's a handoff. And that run produces a decent gain. Ninth play of the drive coming up. This is a tough third and long. To throw, it's Orgy. Makes the grab on the move. So here comes the kicking team on the field. They'll settle for three. Knocks that one right down the middle. And they add to their lead.
And that one, my gosh, I mean, it's almost too easy. Nice kick.
So after adding to this big lead, they'll set to kick it away. He's going to bring it out of the end zone from a couple yards deep. And he stopped with the 18. Returner trying to make a play, but a touchback would have been a better idea. The North Carolina offense is back out there on the field. This is not the time to settle for field goals. They've got to find the end zone here. Opening play of the drive, he looks right for a completion. The tackle is made, but there's a flag on the field. Let's see what that's about. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. Big guys up front lined up. It's first down. With the catch, it's Hampton. Gets past the tackler into open space now. Breaks clear, end zone ahead. They bring him down, but not before an explosive play through this offense through the air.
Boy, just a great job by this quarterback of being able to put this ball up into the air to give his receiver a chance to time that up perfectly for a huge gain for the offense.
And the Tar Heels hustle to the line to run the hurry up. Scanning the field, it's Johnson. The ball is caught, and he'll step out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage there. The defense pursuit forced him out. Second down. important second down play coming up. From the shotgun, drops back looking for an open man. He's going to be brought down by that ferocious pass on this nice sack.
Well, how about the push up front by the big fellas here? And when you can get pressure like this, that's what separates good defenses from great defenses. And you think back to the Michigan teams, when they've been exceptional, they've had defensive line play just like that.
Urgency now for the offense. They'd hate to come up empty on this drive, down multiple scores. Offense flinching before the snap. That'll cost them five.
False start offense.
Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. Important third down play coming up. Quarterback drops back. We're going to test the secondary. Running back grabs it on a screen.
A lot of times this can be a tough play to defend because you're so concerned with getting pressure on the quarterback. But here the defense does a good job of coming off of coverage and chasing down the receiver.
And out comes the field goal unit. This will be an attempt from 52 yards. Let's see if he's got the distance. The kick is good. He knocked it right down the middle.
Boy, this guy had plenty of leg here, too. Chris, you remember the days when a kick from 50-plus was a major accomplishment? Now these guys knock these out like they're almost automatic.
Following the field goal, the kickoff team is out there now.
Set to advance on the football.
He'll return it from inside the five. And the coverage team gets the returner to the ground. And the Wolverines offense is back on the field. That last possession produced a field goal, but more importantly, it milked the clock. And they do that again. They bring him down right at the 20.
I know this defense worked very hard at halftime to come up with answers on how to try to slow down this running back after the big first half, and he's already at it again.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Hand off to the right side. He shreds the tackle. And he's brought down, but he does have enough for the first down.
Coaches told us in the pregame production meetings they love this back's mixture of speed and power. We know about the speed, but he also showed the ability to break tackles on that run.
First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? Takes the handoff. It's Edwards. That's a nice wrap up there by the junior.
The defense coordinator this week already telling us about gap integrity, not giving this running back any creases at all. Really sound defense on that play.
Second down after that run on the previous play. They'll switch it up, looking to throw. Caught on the outside. It's Edwards. So it's third and long from the 29. Will the defense play coverage or blitz? Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. Quarterback escapes the pocket and takes off. Breaks loose at the 40. Quarterback gets down to avoid the tackle.
Well, Chris, that's a great example of why we see these college football coaches bringing in baseball coaches to teach these quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy? Make sure he doesn't get hurt. And that's exactly what he did on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and then pick up the first down.
Keeping it on the ground here. Defense makes the stop after a five-yard gain, so second and five.
This is a good, solid game, 5 or 6 yards. Love to see that from the running game.
game makes it second and medium. Fakes the handoff, looking to throw.
Caught quickly.
Defense wraps him up after the catch, but he's just short of the first down.
It's a small gain by the fullback, but nice to see him and his hand make a play.
So the ball placed right at the 50. Offense looking to pick up the first down here on third and short. Can he make it to the marker? Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there.
This running back's had a big night, kind of night you dream about, but the defense finally steps up and gets to him behind the line of scrimmage.
The Wolverines will have to punt this one away. He's on to kick it away, helping his team with field position. Oh, and it lands at the 4 and bounces in for a touchback. And the Tar Heels offense is back out on the field. They were fortunate to get points on the last possession because of a long-range field goal.
A pop pass on the jet sweep.
They'll tackle him right at the 25-yard line.
And that jet sweep action puts so much pressure on a defense. You get so locked in on the ball, attacking you downhill. When offenses sprinkle this kind of offense in, it stretches this defense out wide and can create some vertical seams for big plays.
Offense coming to the line, they might have a chance for a couple more plays before we reach the end of the quarter.
Quick pass, here comes a jet sweep.
Tackle after he makes the first down as the seconds tick away here in the third quarter. So, Kirk, Michigan has the lead here at the end of the quarter. So, after three quarters of play, it's a pretty solid lead. Let's take a look at our game stats, how we got here. So, one final quarter to play. It's going to take a lot to turn this game around, but strange things do happen in college football. Dropping back, it's Johnson. Quick completion to the tight end. Tackle's made, but not before he makes the 43-yard line. This drive is going now.
And there's the tight end who shows off his hands.
And the Tar Heels come to the line to start a fresh set of downs. Looking to throw again. It's a short completion to the tight end. They make the tackle, but that pass creates a solid gain. As the tight end flex out into the slot, looking for a matchup there, Kirk.
Well, it is a matchup because he has the size where he's very difficult to be able to match up for his safety. And he's got the speed to be able to outrun a linebacker. That's why they like to flex him out like that and be able to pick up nice big gains like this.
Second down, we're going to throw it. Pass ball is incomplete. There was a lot of contact. No penalty. Brings up third down. Fakes the handoff here, looking to throw it.
Snags the quick throw.
And that game will pick up a first down and move the football to the 36. And that completion, Kirk, puts him over 300 yards passing today.
Yeah, anytime a quarterback has a day like this, really it all has to come together with the offensive line play, the receivers running these great routes, and he's just in sync. He's kind of in that zone right now, and he'll be the first one to tell you how much his teammates have helped him out today.
Play action here on first down. But they can't make the connection. Ball's incomplete. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. And he's back to throw again on 2nd and 10. It's a short completion to the big tight end. And a player is down injured after that last play. We'll take a timeout while they check him out. They come to the line, a long way to go for the first down, but needing this crucial conversion right now. Dropping back, it's Johnson. Here's a throw underneath to the tight end. And he's brought down just short of the marker on that play. Good job by the defense to prevent the first down.
I really like what this defensive coordinator is doing right now. He's got a nice lead. Just sit back. The most important thing is tackling this offense inbounds so that clock will keep ticking.
Well, here we go again. The field goal team is out there. This kicker's already got three makes in this game. And he's got it from 47 yards away, showing off the deep range.
Oh, Chris, it's a nice kick here to polish off that drive with at least 3 points up on the board.
So after coming away with three in that drive, the kickoff team is out. And here's the return from inside the five. And they stop him at the 23. That's solid coverage. And the Michigan offense back out on the field. Trying to build on their lead, they were forced to punt on the last possession. On the run, it's Edwards.
Man, I like the run play here. And offensively, at this point in the game, you want to remain in that attack mode first, while also staying in bounds and working that clock.
Second down play coming up for this offense. Drops back from the shotgun, looking for an open man. It's a quick grab. They've got him, but not before making first down yards to move them well to the 41.
Chris, that's another nice pickup through the air. I thought they might be really just out to run the football here with the lead. But instead, they're electing to throw the football. Different routes, quarterbacks in rhythm. Really, it's almost an extension of their passing game.
Here's the handoff. Fights through the tackler.
Hey, you got to do what you got to do. You got to rely on that offensive line, the running game here, to be able to secure a victory. Good call, and just keep working that clock.
Here's the second down play. Dropping back, it's Orgy. He's on the run, launches deep. Receiver left alone down there for a huge gain.
Man, they're already up big in this game, and now they're taking shots downfield. They're just looking to pour it on right now. Still throwing the football in vertical shots to boot.
The Wolverines pick up enough yards to move the sticks. Quick throw, the catch is made. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that.
I love the call here with the wide receiver screen. Where's he going to go? Blockers do not do their job and open up any running lanes at all.
Good job bleeding the clock on this drive so far. They'll come up on a second down. From the shotgun, handoff inside. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Boy, these obvious running situations are very tough when you're working with the lead late in the game, because you know the defense is going to stack the line of scrimmage, make it as difficult as possible for you to run the football. So nice job there by the defense. They're trying to punch that ball out, do anything they can at all to get the ball back.
Takes the handoff again. He's not going to get the first down. It's fourth down now. So the decision is to not go for it, but settle for three. Here comes the field goal team. And the importance of this attempt, if he makes it, it's now a three-score game. And it sails right through the middle of the uprights. Solid kick. And that will extend their lead even further.
Snap, the hold, the kick, everything there perfect to put 3 points up here for the offense.
Oh, set for the kickoff here after adding to this big lead. And it comes out of the 25. No return attempted there. And here comes the North Carolina offense back out onto the field. It's hard to win these games just kicking field goals. They need to find the end zone here. Some urgency.
Oh, it's dropped off the tip by the defense there. It's going to bring up second down.
In college football today, the quarterbacks get rid of the ball often so fast. Now, this is a great example for young players on the defensive line. If you can't get to the quarterback, watch their eyes and try to get your hands up so when the ball comes, you can knock it away.
QB tries it again here on second and 10. Quarterback looks to his right and finds his man. And it's good for a first down to the 36.
How about this guy making this throw? I mean, they have harassed him all game long, and here we are in the fourth quarter. He takes another hit, and this time gets enough on it to be able to complete it. Great play by the quarterback.
First down play call. How aggressive will it be? Looking to throw. It's Johnson.
Makes a quick grab.
And he's brought down, but there is a flag on the field. Let's check out this call.
Personal foul. Look at the pass. Defense.
Quarterback roughed up. Let's hope he's okay. Automatic first down coming. From the shotgun, drops back. Finds that big tight end for a short pass. That's a big game before he goes out of bounds. It'll move the sticks more than enough for a first down.
That's what makes this tight end so dangerous. You can flex him out into that slot position. He shows you his versatility. He can be an inline guy that can block, but here he shows you what he can do with his hands.
And the Tar Heels hustle to the line to run the hurry up. Looking to throw yet again. And a short pitch and catch to the tight end. They bring him down quickly. A short pitch and catch. Get a little bit closer to the marker.
I love what the defense is doing here. Sitting back, giving up some plays underneath, tackling these guys inbounds, and just keep that clock rolling.
Second down play coming up. Little eye candy here from the offense. Some pre-snap motion. Pass is incomplete, but a flag is down in the backfield. They may have roughed the quarterback. Yeah, you simply cannot hit the quarterback like that. He got caught red-handed. In the red area, it's Hampton. And he stopped just short, down to the two, but an excellent run.
Well, depending on the temperament of the head coach, he's either turning to the bench and screaming, "Where in the heck was that all game?" Or maybe he's just kind of keeping that to himself, thinking, "All right, maybe this is something to build on. Maybe something positive can come out of this. You're going to have some bad games from time to time." We'll see how he gets his team ready in the future. But that right there, man, that's what they've been looking for all game.
Muscles across the goal line. Touchdown, Tar Heels.
Boy, as a defensive coordinator, you've got to be careful being so worried about this pass game and this quarterback that you're a little bit soft up front and it costs you. It's exactly what happened here as they score this touchdown.
See if they can convert the point after. PAT is good. They still trail, though.
That makes the score Michigan 36, North Carolina.
Here's the kickoff team now, set to boot this one away.
Set to kickoff.
Fields it just outside the goal line. And he's tackled at the 21. That's where the drive will start. And the Michigan offense comes back out on the field. They settled for a field goal last time. Let's see what they can come up with on this possession. And there's the handoff. It's good for a 3-yard gain, so second and 7.
one.
This is where the offensive line can really assert their will and put on the finishing touches to this game. The defense, you can see them. They're breaking little by little right now. You make sure they break completely.
Second down after that previous play. And, of course, they'll work the clock here, keep it on the ground. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
My gosh, this offensive line's got to do a better job of blocking. The defense was zeroed in on the ball carrier and absolutely nowhere to go for the offense.
Offense been in reverse here. Now a long way to go to convert this third down. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. Short connection to the tight end here. And a big game before he goes out of bounds. The offense keeps churning, gets a fresh set of downs.
You know, they've got a lead here late in the game, and the play calling, I think, shows you how much confidence they have in this quarterback. He's had a pretty clean game today, and this decision to still throw the ball with the lead shows you that they believe he's going to make the right decisions and make the accurate throws.
And here's the handoff. The junior able to bring him down quickly.
Boy, we got a smart offensive coordinator on our hands today, Chris. Great job of just keep feeding this running back, keep it on the ground, working with the lead in the fourth quarter, force them to use all their timeouts, and just keep working that clock.
Second down after that run on the previous play. And the tailback's got it again. And he's tackled just short of the midfield line at the 49.
Well, this is a huge third down coming up here, and here's where that chess match comes to head. And for the defense, they desperately need to make a play if they believe they have any chance of coming back to win this game.
And that's the two-minute warning as this offense tries to work the clock, getting closer now to an impressive victory. The linebacker shifting around now. This is a big third down play coming up. If they can get the stop, you have to believe we'd see a timeout. Try and muscle for the first down. Brought down, but it's past the line to gain. And now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible. And the wideout goes in motion. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. And they tackle him, but a nice pickup on that running play. Now a timeout taken by the defense, trying to preserve as much clock as possible for their offense. Ball handed off. He shrinks the tackle. And he'll head out of bounds, but not before picking up enough for a first down.
You're starting to see this defense, I think, wear down now that we're in the fourth quarter. It's been a tough day for them, and the offense is taking advantage of it. A lot of positive plays, good job of eating as much clock as they can here on this drive in the fourth quarter.
Running game is working. They'll stick with it on first down. And a nice first down gain there. They get him down, but very close to the first down marker. Now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible. And the Wolverines are in the red zone. Oh, it's a reverse. Tackle, but forced down.
Chris, that's a play where they're designed to try to trick the defense. Now, they didn't gain a huge chunk of yards, but the good news is they did pick up a first down.
The Wolverines lining up here on first and 10. And now it's victory formation. The quarterback will just kneel down.